Let's find some music.
We got the beat, we've got the beat.
I'm Vanessa Joy with Adorama TV, and I'm gonna show you how to make it look like you're shooting outdoors, even when you're inside. Your entire Instagram is filled with light, airy, whimsical, and dreamy photos. But when it's time to take photos on the wedding day, it's snowing, it's a hurricane, it's a tornado.
Still good.
Well, here's how you make it look like you're outside, even though you're inside. First things first, steal foliage, bring it up an elevator three stories, and put it where you want to take photos.
We're in the woods, in the elevator.
Step two, you need two lights. I chose a Profoto B1 and a Profoto B10. If I was just shooting indoors with a normal exposure, this is what it would look like. It's okay, other than the fact that I put a plant on a table back there and it looks really weird, but we can make this look so much better. First thing you wanna do is you wanna take that B1 and point it at the biggest source possible. I'm pointing it in the direction of a corner, actually, and it's reflecting off all the walls and the ceiling. As much as you can get that light to hit, let it hit and reflect back, light colored, so that it's not reflecting anything weird back at them. I set my camera settings and then I put my Profoto on TTL and let it do the rest of the work. We've got an okay picture from there. It looks fine, but now we're gonna add the magic. I like the power of the light that's hitting their face, so I'm going to switch from TTL to manual, so I hold that light power. Then I'm gonna switch my light, which I've set to group A, off. So I'm gonna turn it off on my transmitter so it won't fire. Now to add my second light, I'm gonna take my B10 and put an orange gel on it. Why orange? Because the sun is orange and warm and wonderful, and I want to make sure that the light coming from behind them mimics the sun. I'm gonna throw that light behind the foliage so it looks like the light is coming from behind some random tree that they're standing in front of. Then I'm gonna take a picture, setting again, back to TTL so that Profoto can determine the correct amount of light that's gonna come from that B10. Reminder, that other Profoto B1, the head is turned off, so nothing's being affected over there. I'm just letting TTL work on the B10 light that's coming from behind. And then I can adjust it up or down. I did choose to adjust it a little bit down because it was a little bit too bright. And then I turned on the Profoto B1 again and fired them both at the same time. And this is what we got. Beautiful light on their faces, gorgeous light coming from behind them. Now I know what you're looking at this. There's a light stand, I know. Don't worry, don't get excited. I'm gonna crop it, not in post. We're not doing things in post. Get a different crop so that you're cutting out the light stand and most of the flare, but if you want to, you know, you still can have the flare come in like that. And it just looks like they're outside in the sun where a little bit of light is just peeking through the foliage back there. It's freaking incredible. My brides get a kick out of this. They absolutely love that I can take an indoor location and make it look like they're outside in the greenery, looking amazing. Feel free to do anything you want with this, by the way. You can pose them differently. You can get little details like I did here of the dress. Oh my God, she's so cute. I can't. And yes, I know, they're dress clips there. Kleinfelds gave us these dresses, but they're not tailored, so we have to clip them. So just get lots of different poses of them looking like it's outside. You can guarantee the sun on any possible wedding day.
Looking for more inspiration? Click the link in the description below to download my free posing guide.
Hit the subscribe button and the bell to make sure you're notified when new videos pop up here on Adorama TV. Leave some comments, ask your questions. There are no dumb questions and there's no such thing as mean comments. There is such a thing as mean comments. I collect the mean comments, so I have an excuse to eat ice cream. But seriously, don't be a